Hey guys, welcome to the video today. This video is just gonna be like showing something that I've been doing a little bit on, you know, just kind of like, you know, when I was bored. This was basically, this game, Ultimate Coaster 2, as you can tell, I'm on my phone here. And, I've been making these roller coasters that have been at a theme park that is in Pennsylvania that I used to go to a lot when I lived in New York. And basically, in this game, Ultimate Coaster 2, you can basically really just make, like, coaster, like, any coaster that you want. Unfortunately, you can't really make any coaster that you want, because any coaster besides the box spine sit-down, the single spine inverted, and the wooden, two rows, every other coaster besides these three, you have to actually pay money for. It's $2 per one, and then if you wanted to get all of them, it'd be $20. So if I ever get them, if I ever get all of them, or get the, or at least get the ones that I need, for the certain ones, then, it's really easy to change them. It's really easy to change them. You just have to, like, do, like, one thing, and then they all change. But they have, like, basically every single, like, different type of coaster. And I've been making a lot of coasters at this theme park that's called Hershey Park in Pennsylvania. I recommend you go. It's a really good theme park. You should definitely go. But it's really good, and I used to go a lot. I still do go a lot, and they change or add something every single year, which makes them pretty unique, so that's pretty cool. So I'm gonna go over all the ones that I have so far. So this was the most recent roller coaster that they've added in Hershey Park. Now, some of these are not really made that well. Like, you'll see, like, the first, like, two hills in this coaster aren't really that good. Because I kind of, this was the first coaster, well, the second coaster that I made. But I've gotten a little bit better at making it, but again, keep in mind, I'm really not that good at making stuff, so please don't say that I'm, like, that it's bad. I know, like, that hill's not really that good. I mean, the bottom of it's good because I kind of made it rotate. But this one's called Candymonium because, you know, it's Hershey and stuff, and it's, like, themed with all the Hershey colors and stuff. So, most of the coasters that you see will be this type of coaster that you're looking at right now, because this is the basic one that it gives you, but I probably will eventually get some of the different coasters, and I'll, like, retheme the ones that need to be rethemed. Now, there's supposed to be three coasters in this one. I tried to make it work, but whenever I would do it, it just, like, wouldn't work. I don't know why. It just wouldn't work. But that's it for that one. Then we got the Comet, which the Comet for Hershey Park is the first, like, roller coaster that was open to the public in Hershey Park. That is loud. I wish there was a way to turn off the volume in this game. But, let me get onto the ride. It goes up the hill, eventually. It's kind of a slow hill. This ride is about, like, 60, 80 feet. The other one was 210 feet high. This one's about 80 feet, I would say. So, it's kind of high, but not that high. Now, I don't know if you guys ever go to Hershey Park website, I recommend you do, because they have a bunch of POVs on there, too, and they show everything else, too, because obviously I can only make coasters in this game, but they also have water slides, and they have a lot of flat rides, too, and so when you look at the videos on the coasters on their, website, which basically you would go to explore, and then you click coasters, like, I tried to sync up the coaster with, like, the music that it plays in the backgrounds of the, I tried to, like, sync the music up with the, or sync the coaster up with the music that it plays in the background, in the POV videos that they have on their website, and, Really, most of the part for almost all the coasters, the music only syncs up with the hill, and that's it. And then it kind of just like goes off a little bit. They actually got Skyrush, which was their original tallest roller coaster, but then they made Candemonium like a year or two ago. So this one, the chain lift really like starts off really slow and then it gets really fast. So now we're going up pretty fast. We're going up at about 15 miles an hour right now. And this roller coaster is about 200 feet. So yeah, this one's 200 feet. And you know, it does a bunch of this. And I know, guys, please don't get annoyed about it. I know my transitions aren't that good. And some turns are kind of, you know, sharp like that turn. And they don't bank. Or they bank too much. Or, you know. And I mean, okay, this part, that, I know that that's not clean. But I'm pretty sure that, like, in, yeah, and also that, I know that's not clean either. But in Skyrush, that actually, they actually have those kind of things like that. It's really, I've been on it before. It's really, like, I don't know, it's really weird. Like, the really sharp turns and stuff. Then we got a Great Bear, which is their only inverted coaster. It's the only inverted coaster that they have at the park. All the other coasters are not inverted. They're all just a normal one where it lays on the tracks, but this one obviously lays under the tracks where you would have your feet dangle and stuff. The thing that I love about this coaster is this coaster is like really smooth. Like, if you ever go to Hershey Park and you're tall enough, I recommend you go onto this coaster, and I recommend you go into Candemonium. And all the good coasters are like the taller ones, honestly, in my opinion. And I really recommend you go on this one, though. This one's really smooth and nice. This one's a just overall really nice ride. Although, I will say, the last time that I've been on this roller coaster, my restraint may or may not have popped a little bit. I don't know what it was, but my restraint kind of, like, popped a little bit. And I was just holding on to it for the rest of the ride, just in case. Obviously, I didn't fall or anything. The restraint was still there. Like, it didn't pop all the way open. It just kind of, like, popped up a little bit, just a tiny bit. And it was, I was just, you know, I was a little scared. I was like, what the heck? But trust me, that's not going to happen if you go on it. They're very secure. It's probably just because I was pretty small when I was going on it. Like, I was barely tall enough to go on it. So, that's probably why. So next, this one is Super Duper Looper. This, as you guys can see, this one's a way much more of a sharper, or way much more of a shorter, not sharper, way much more of a shorter coaster. It's kind of for the smaller ones. I would say if you ever go to Hershey Park, a good coaster to start off with, or like to get used to it, and also just a good coaster to get your first loop would be Super Duper Looper, and or Comet would be like the best ones to kind of start off with to get yourself kind of in the mood. But if you're like an intense rider, you just want to go, and you get like Candemonium, Skyrush, Great Bear, especially Stormrunner. Stormrunner goes like 0 to 75 miles an hour in like 2 seconds. We'll get to Stormrunner in a minute. But this one is not really as amusing. It's a big terrain coaster. I don't know if you guys, well, I mean, I haven't added any terrain in any of these, but I probably will eventually. But I want to get all the coasters done first, and then I will add all the terrain around it. And, yeah, that one's pretty boring. That one's got two. Next, we got Trailblazer. Okay, so this ride, that I made it in, it may or may not kind of just crash into pieces of the track there, just, like, right there. It kind of crashed into pieces of the track from, it was hard to keep it kind of in its spot. And just like Super Duper Looper, I don't know if you guys could tell, but that one was kind of, like, losing speed at the end. And just stuff, it was just not really, it was not good there. It was losing a lot of speed. This one also loses speed. It's just hard to give it a good enough speed when it's like, it has, like, no height at all. This one, I believe, is smaller than Super Duper Looper. This one's also a pretty big terrain coaster. I wouldn't say it's as much as Super Duper Looper, but it's a lot with terrain, too. Like, it goes a lot around, like, rocks and trees and bushes, and it goes in the ground a little bit. Not like in the ground, like underground, but I mean like it kind of goes in this like slant in the ground. at one point. And I would say the ride Trailblazer is a lot more longer than that. A lot more longer than that, but mine is a lot more shorter. Then we got Storm Runner. And this one, like I said, goes like 0 miles to 75 miles an hour in like 2 seconds. So we're going to get to that in a minute. I don't know if you guys can see down there, but the difference. And the thing that I love about this coaster is that it plays like this audio right before you get boosted. It says like, now get ready, here we go. And it's really cool. And it's also really cool because when you're just like walking on like the sidewalk that's like under next to Storm Runner, like you can see all the people before they launch, and it's really fun to kind of just like watch them just sit there and then get launched. It's pretty nice. So this one's got some inversions. It's got, I mean, like, technically you can say it has one inversion, but I don't know if, here, I'm gonna show you guys. I don't know if this technically counts as an inversion. Okay, it's also really annoying to move in this game. It's kind of confusing, so if you guys ever get this game, it's a little confusing to move at first when you start playing this game. Okay, do you guys technically count this as an inversion? I don't think it counts, but I'm not sure, because it basically goes upside down, but then it, like, turns the last second to not really make it upside down. Now, the thing is, I would know, but I've never actually been on Storm Runner, because the one time that I was able to, I was actually tall enough. I finally got tall enough to go on Storm Runner, and I was really excited, but then we found out that it was closed for the season, and I was really upset, because it was my one chance I could finally go on it, and then it was closed for the entire season. It's opened back up again, but a lot of Hershey Park's roller coasters have been, like, a lot of the tall ones have been having some problems. Okay, so this one's Sidewinder. It's basically a boomerang coaster. Now, I will say, it's not this color. I didn't color any of it. It's still, like, the basic colors. It normally, it's, like, a black track and kind of, like, a reddish, maroonish kind of color thing. Now, there's no actual way to make it go backwards, and then go up a chain lift and then drop and then go through the station and then do this. So, technically, it has two... technically it has three inversions, but watch this. You're gonna go backwards now. And technically, does this count as going six inversions? Because you're doing those three going backwards? I don't know. You guys gotta tell me what you think. And that's it. It kind of just keeps going on forever and ever and ever. So I just have to stop it. And then this is the last one. I didn't actually add, like, really anything. I didn't, like, get done with the hill yet. But I got a little bit of the hill. This one's called Fahrenheit, and it goes up, like, a straight up 90 degree hill, and then it has, like, a 97 degree drop, which basically that means it goes more than just straight down. It actually goes back a little bit than straight down in the drop, so that's pretty cool. I'm gonna go up a chain lift there. But, and that's it. So, I recommend you guys get Ultimate Coaster if you guys like building these stuff, or Ultimate Coaster, whatever you want to call it. But those are all the coasters that I made so far for Hershey Park. I recommend you kind of check it out if you guys like theme parks and you like roller coasters and stuff. It's really a fun experience to go there, and they even have this whole chocolate tour ride that kind of shows you how they make their chocolate, and I really recommend you check Hershey Park out. It's a really amazing theme park, and it's just, like, it's been a theme park that I go to so much for, like, my entire life. I've been going there a lot, and it's so fun to see how much Hershey Park develops, because, like, they add something new, or they change something every single year, and it's really just, it's really just cool to see it, and I don't know. But I hope you guys check it out. If you guys enjoy theme parks and roller coasters and stuff, I recommend you do that. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. You guys already know what I say every single outro, so just kind of do what I say every single outro, you know. Like if you enjoyed, subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. Hit the notification bell so you never miss any of my future videos, because I'm posting videos every single day. And I'm thinking about doing this thing called Minecraft Mondays, because I'm really enjoying Minecraft right now, and I can even get my friends on Minecraft now because I just got something on my Nintendo Switch where I can do that. But I don't know, you guys let me know. I was thinking about doing something called like Minecraft Mondays, where I do a video on Minecraft every single Monday. And you guys can let me know, but let me know if you guys want that, because I won't do it if you guys don't want me to. I just won't make a video on it if you guys don't want me to. But as always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. Yeah, that's it.